Hello my people, my machines and machine freaks. I hope you guys are enjoying your day, having a froggy fresh one at that. I am here with the Jeep. The Jeep pieces. It's not a Jeep right now. So you guys know the plan. I want everything on this taken apart, cleaned up, powder coated, not painted, because I want this thing to last forever. Basically, I build this thing when I'm 23 years old, and I have it when I'm dead, or if I wanna, whatever, just so that it lasts a very, very long time. And that's not to say that we're trying to build a bulletproof everything right now, we're just trying to start with a bulletproof frame. So that way, we're never taking this frame apart, we're not patching, or reinforcing the frame later on. That's something that we're going to accomplish right now. However, people keep on bringing up these differentials because we have a Dana 30 in the front, which isn't a very strong front differential, and then we have a Dana 35 in the rear that isn't a very strong differential as well. That's what all the critics are saying. However, there are a lot of supporters of the Dana 30 and the Dana 35. It's been really controversial. It's kind of like the whole Trump thing. You got this side and you got that side, and there's not really too much in between. A lot of people are saying stick with the Dana 30 in the front end, which I'm leaning more towards. And then a lot of people are saying if I upgrade the Dana 35, I have just as much money as if I were to invest it in a Dana 44. Or a Dana 60, or a Ford 8.8, or a Ford 9-inch, is it, or is it a 7-inch? I can't remember. So I will update you guys right now, and that is I am going to go with the Dana 30 in the front end, unless somebody out there or a couple people have gone through a situation where they're breaking their Dana 30s. Now, I don't want to see a comment that's like, yeah, I had this, you know, Dana 30, I never put lubricant in it, and I ran it, and it blew apart, and it's no good. I want somebody who has had some experience with, like, you know, taking care of their stuff and then, like, putting it through minor obstacles and then breaking it.
I mean, if you're trying to pull a SpongeBob and trying to go up a 90 degree hill and breaking the thing, that's also something that I'm not going to run into.
And then by not doing this, if I do break the front differential in the future, then we just replace it. We make it better. But that's, I don't want, you know, something stupid like the front differential getting in the way of this entire project.
We gotta keep moving this thing forward. Little update on the BMW, I do have parts for this.
However, I don't really have room in the warehouse to install them just yet.
And just like that, I got the engine, the transmission, and the transfer case moved to the side there. Have the frame sitting here in the warehouse. It's all by itself, it's ready to be powder coated. Sandblasted, I apologize. We gotta make it clean before we make it cleaner. Front differential sitting over here next to the tools, and it doesn't have the best gear oil in it, that is for sure. That's what came out of it, and that is brown like the mud. And then we have our rear differential here, and now I'm going to finally see what our gear ratio is on this thing. There's no way I'm going to be able to read anything that's here if it was even here. So I guess the first thing is let's see if this is an LSD, a limited slip differential. So if I spin this axle this way, that other side should spin with it if it's a LSD. So we're going clockwise on this side. Oh, we're going counterclockwise on that side. So now I gotta chuck off one of these sides so I can count how many times this yoke's going to spin. So with the power of technology, I can see both the yoke and the hub. I'm going to turn the hub 10 times and see how many times this yoke turns.
One on the yoke. Two on the yoke, and that was our first time around the hub. 13, 14. So what happened was I spun the hub 10 times, then I multiplied the number that the yoke spun by 2. It was originally 20.55. Multiply that by 2, it's like 41.11. Divide that by 10, you got 410.
So that's the gear ratio of that differential right there. We may as well check to see if this is a matching set. I don't want to be running like 3.73 in this one and then like 410 here.
That definitely will not be any good. So we'll check them. We'll throw them on the jack stands and we'll check it. Before we get to that second differential, I do want to remind you guys I am doing another giveaway. Our last giveaway winner was Damien H. He won the GoPro. This time I'm going to give away one of these suckers. This guy comes in all different colors. Red, blue, black, white, and pink. All you gotta do to enter is go to machinemerch.com, get something super froggy fresh, whether it be a hat, a t-shirt, a decal, anything. For every $4.99 you spend, you earn yourself an entry. It's only gonna be 1 week long. Not a lot of machine freaks take advantage of this, so go ahead and enter. I will send this directly to your house. Not this one, I'm going to send you a brand new one because I'll probably break this one. For all the rules and details, go to machinemerch.com. Good luck. Let's see this diff.
One of the benefits of having a seized up caliper is you don't have to take your 18 inch pry bar or breaker bar and somehow manage to lock up the hub. Froze up caliper works much, much better.
Do a little marking. Let the confusion begin. 5, 6. Thank goodness. We have the same as the back end, which is good. We got 410 all the way around. We're not running like 3.55 or 3.73. I guess these are gear ratios Jeep offered from my readings. We're not running dissimilar gear ratios, which is good, because otherwise you'd have some binding up. You'd have the rear end going this fast, and then you'd have the front end going a different rate, and then it would not work at all.
So for you that don't want to change your differential fluids, or you somehow go off-roading or you get into an accident and you're just like, okay, I got to replace my front differential or my rear differential, you have to keep in mind, yes, you need a front differential, but you also need matching gears.
Tell you the truth, I'm not too big of a fan of differentials at this point in time.
I definitely like something that I can literally cut in half, re-weld the way I want to. For these, you can't really do that.
Now I'm headed to my girlfriend's. Her family is having a birthday party for her. So wish the biggest machine freak in the comment section a happy birthday. She would appreciate it, I would appreciate it. While I'm up there, Danny might have his new rig up there. You guys, I had a couple videos of his Ram Charger on when we were changing the engine. My only duty was to take the one engine out of the one Ram Charger, put it in this truck, and then he was supposed to ship it off to another mechanic to get other things done, such as the body and all sorts of things. So last year, like 2017, late April, Danny bought two Ram Chargers. He made a make-a-wish. I'm at his vehicle right now. It previously looked like this.
Okay, hopefully something there.
Now it looks like this. What color red is this?
Candy apple red.
That's a candy apple red? These were originally silver, weren't they? If
yeah.
I do remember.
They
made them
silver.
Black.
They it's blacked like a... out the bumpers and grill.
Yep.
And the Ram head.
Yep, they did that. The
wench on it was no good, right? So that's
it was shot.
He's already taken out his first victim here. What is, you got a moth, no good. Did the exhaust come out here to begin with, Danny?
Yeah, that's how it was.
That's how it was?
Mm-hmm. When I start up, it looks like a freaking.
I know it looks like a diesel. I know he had a get together yesterday. It was revealed to him for the very first time, and he took out of the place. He took out of the parking lot like a bat out of hell.
It starts a little hard, but when it's running, it runs a lot better than how it did before.
Yeah.
Originally, it's raining here, so I apologize if it's... Danny bought two of these things. He wanted to take the engine from the one and put it into this one. I told him I would take on that task for him to save him some time and some money.
After we put the engine in this, then he took it to a mechanic. From that mechanic, it went to another mechanic. From that mechanic, it went to another mechanic. And
well,
now...
from the Make-A-Wish, mechanics of Make-A-Wish.
And then they finally got it to run.
Yep.
They finally got it to run.
So I originally never wanted to make it run at all. I just told him, hey, I can literally take that engine, put it into this one so that you're further ahead.
We got that accomplished for you.
Yep.
And then they took the rest away. So they got your new seats here. Oh, new steering wheel?
Yep.
Was the seat all ripped up, or was it even in its place?
It was a little torn up, but the driver's seat was really torn up.
Yeah, so what's up with these cup holders? Is that how they used to do it back in the day?
I don't know, because those are not very good cup holders.
They must have been for like drive-ins or something where you just like set them. It wasn't something that you're supposed to drive around with, that is for sure. That must be like a drive-in thing. That's
probably
the only thing I can think of.
Yeah.
And then what did you put here? Maybe your box of popcorn or something?
Maybe.
Because what year is this? It's the
88.
88.
You could watch movies on that thing.
Can you really?
Yeah. There's already a movie in there, The Goonies.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Turn that on. I want to see that.
Oh, that's sweet. Dude, now that we're on that subject, can we take that DVD and see if my DVD player works in my truck? Before we do that, though, we're going to show you how this thing starts and what it looks like when it starts.
Ah, Danny, let it rip, tater chip. The rain kind of made it less smoky, but you could see some smoke. Old American power.
All right, so this is in the back of my truck, and I've had this thing forever. I want to see if this thing finally works.
No disc.
No disc.
Oh, I hear some noises. Come on, baby. Gary needs a new pair of shoes. Oh my goodness.
Wow.
That's awesome. We both got entertainment systems. Do you have a police siren on yours though?
There's one last thing that I have to mention. There was a machine freak in the comment section that said he had two Dana 44s. So I'm contacting you. Any support is appreciated, and I appreciate support like that. Stay froggy fresh, stay super fly. Until next time, put as much advice in the comment section as you can. We all learn together. People scroll down, they look at what you have to say. Some people swear back at you if you swear at me. It's a really, really good time. One last thing, if you want to get a free entry in on that RC vehicle, follow me on Twitter, tell me in the comment section that you followed me, you'll earn one free entry. Stay froggy fresh, stay super fly. Until next time, this Jeep isn't going to put itself together. Pretty shit out.